Hey everyone, Daniel here with another tutorial for you, and this time I'm going to show you how to create a Windows 10 bootable DVD. I'll have the link in the description below, but you'll go to this website and scroll down to create Windows 10 installation media and then download the tool. Save that to your hard drive and remember where it's stored so you can run it later. Find the file that you downloaded and run it. It will extract the files and begin the setup process to create the program that will allow you to set up an ISO file for your DVD. 25 seconds later, in my case, I'm able to accept the license agreement and continue waiting. Another 25 seconds later, I have the option of either upgrading this computer or creating the installation media, which includes the DVD. Here you can use the same settings based on the computer you're on, or if you're setting this disk up for a different computer, you can choose from the language, edition, and 64-bit versus 32-bit, and you can even include both options on here if you wanted to. Choose the options that make sense for you and hit next, and then you've got the option of a USB or an ISO image, which is what we want for a DVD drive, and then you can save that ISO image to anywhere on your computer. Just choose where you're going to save the file, give it a name, and hit save. Then it's going to begin downloading the full installation package based on the selections you chose earlier. It will very quickly verify the download before it starts creating the Windows 10 installation media, which for me took 7 minutes on a solid state drive. Once it's ready, you can click Open DVD Burner if you have DVD Burner software. If not, you're going to have this error message. So instead, just click on Finish and allow it to prepare the ISO image for you to burn manually. Once the ISO image is created, just right-click on it and choose Burn Disk Image. The Windows Disk Image Burner software will open. You can choose the disk drive if it's not already there by default. Choose to verify and click Burn. You'll see that it'll start burning the disk image, and then it'll quickly move on to finalizing the disk and then verifying. And once your disk is burnt, it's a good idea to label it, including the version number. And now you can take that disk that you just created, pop it into your other computer, and boot from that disk, and now you can install or repair Windows. And if you found this video helpful, please do give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more. Thanks so much. We'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.